pray and ask God's blessing on us as we continue our last part of our Advent journey. We pray in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Today, to help us mark this, the fourth Sunday of Advent, the last part of our journey, Emma and Olivia, people going with my help, are going to write the Advent brief for us. As they do, we will ask God's blessing. Lord our God, we praise and thank you for the gift of Jesus, your Son. He is the Word made flesh. He is the firstborn of creation. He is the true light of the world. And together let's proclaim. Turn to the Lord in trust and faith. Lord Jesus, you are the light of the world. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you came to show us and to the way to the Father and enlighten our journey. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you will lead us into the everlasting light of heaven. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on you, forgive you your sins and bring you to life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us pray. Lord, fill our hearts with your love, and as you revealed to us by an angel the coming of your Son, so lead us through his suffering and death to the glory of his resurrection. For he lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God for ever and ever.
Established for forever. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
I will sing forever of your love, O Lord. Through all ages my mouth will proclaim your truth. Of this I am sure, that your love lasts forever, that your truth is firmly established as the heavens.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
I have made a covenant with my chosen one. I have sworn to David, my servant. I will establish your dynasty forever and set up your throne through the ages. He will say to me, "You are my Father, my God, the rock who saves me. I will keep my love for him always. For him my covenant shall endure." A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Glory to him who is able to give you the strength to live according to the good news I preach, and in which I proclaim Jesus Christ. The revelation of a mystery kept secret for endless ages, but now so clear that it must be broadcast to pagans everywhere to bring them to the obedience of faith. This is only what scriptures have predicted, and it is all part of the way the eternal God wants things to be. He alone is wisdom. Give glory, therefore, to him through Jesus Christ forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia. I am the servant of the Lord, may his will be done. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to God.
The angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. The angel went in and said to her, "Rejoice, O highly favored, the Lord is with you." She was deeply disturbed by these words and asked herself what this greeting could mean. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid. You have won God's favor. Listen, you are to conceive and bear a son. You must name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his ancestor David. He will rule over the house of Jacob forever, and his reign will have no end." Mary said to the angel, "But how can this come about, since I am a virgin?" "The Holy Spirit will come upon you," the angel answered, "and the power of the Most High will cover you with its shadow. And so the child will be holy and will be called Son of God. Know this too, your kinswoman, Elizabeth, has in her old age herself conceived a son, and she whom people call barren is now in her sixth month. For nothing is impossible to God." "I am the handmaid of the Lord," said Mary. "Let what you have said be done to me." And the angel left her. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord.
It's quite some time ago now, but when I think back to teenage years and to athletics days, I used to think the longest and hardest 20 metres were the last 20 metres of the 400 metre race. Lactic acid that built up in your muscles and your legs felt like lead. However, on reflection on these teenage years, I think it was a harder 20 metres. This was the distance across the dance floor to ask a girl to dance. One's legs went to leg then as well too. It was a hard decision to make. It was on reflection now, possibly not a life or death decision, but at the time, a decision that was probably a worry, perhaps with some anxiety, some concern, some fear perhaps. What if I'm rejected? What will happen? All of these sorts of things that go through a teenage mind. I was telling some teachers about this a while ago, and one of the women said, you know, Dennis, it was also a long 20 metres if you were a girl waiting on the other side. Now, I share that only because when you think about decisions and about choices, they're not all instant or immediate, are they? They're often accompanied by lots of other feelings and emotions. Forget about dancing for a moment, but think about some of the bigger decisions of your life. And choices, life-giving choices, choices of partnership, choice to enter into marriage, choice to be a parent, choice of friends, choice of careers. Big decisions. Often we come to a point where we say yes to that decision, and it is life-giving, but we don't always reach that immediately. We go through lots of valleys and lots of moments along the journey to say yes to life. It's not always instant. I think that's the same reality that St. Luke in the Gospel today is trying to convey to us about Mary's, Our Lady's response to God. We all grow and we all live our faith in the knowledge of her yes, her affirmation, her assent to God's will. And history is changed forever because of that. It's a momentous decision. But Luke's also trying to show, I think, that it was a very human decision. And some of the language he uses to describe this, the Annunciation, I think is witness to that. Mary wondered what these words could mean and questioned, asked herself, how could this be? Mary knew fear. Don't be afraid, Mary, says the angel. And also Mary kind of wrestled with it logically. How can this be? I'm a virgin. So there's a very human story behind the affirmation, the assent that Mary gave. It's a human story of coming to a decision. It's like our stories. And so what is true in life is also true of our spiritual journeys, our whole relationship to God. One would hope that it's always a yes, a complete assent to all that God invites us to do and to be. But we give that assent in our spiritual life as we do in ordinary life. There's layers. Some things perhaps we're uncertain about. Some things we don't know, and we seek answers. Some things we worry about, perhaps even be afraid of sometimes. All of that's normal and natural. Our spiritual life, in one sense, mirrors our ordinary lives too. The capacities we have in our relationships, in choosing love in life, we also bring to bear when we relate to God. So today is an affirmation, I think, and perhaps an assurance to us all not to be overly anxious about our response to God. That's a response that occurs and draws on our natural capacities too. So we will have moments of question, we will have moments of doubt, we will have moments even when we're completely uncertain. And this is a normal part of being a human being and being a spiritual person. So today the Gospel, I think, is very affirming of our ordinary sharing our lives with God. And there's perhaps one other lovely point, I think, that Luke makes for us. Because it's the final witness, as it were, the final moment that helps Mary to come to her decision to say yes to God, is when she looks at her cousin Elizabeth. And the angel announces that Elizabeth has been faithful all these years, and now that faith is being rewarded, as it were. It's when Mary sees the faith of her cousin that she draws that extra moment of strength, as it were, to be able to say yes to God herself. Again, I think that's a wonderful affirmation for each one of you, for all of us, those watching us today. The importance of your witness, of your regular or deep at times, sometimes even very simple, acts of faith and trust in God. Who knows who is watching and drawing strength from your example, from your witness? And I think that's a very important thing that we all carry too, that we are strengthening each other by our own faithful journey. Whether we're doing that individually or whether people are looking at the whole community and becoming strengthened by that reality, we're all a part of that story too. So today, let's hear the Annunciation as an affirmation too of our own choice for God, and indeed an affirmation of our own witness that help others make their choice for God.
Let's proclaim our faith, our trust in God, as we pray together.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
And so, my sisters and brothers, let's, with trust and faith, present our petitions, our hopes and prayers to God.
Church, that our hearts may be an authentic dwelling place for God, and thus enable us to bring God's presence to all whom we encounter. God ever close.
Hear our prayer.
For a listening heart, that our hearts may be stilled and quietened, so that we may hear the word of God as it comes to us in word, people, and experience each day. God ever close.
Hear our prayer.
For all believers, that we, like Mary, may ponder God's invitations and give our full yes to all that God asks of us, so that God's will may be fulfilled for all the human family. God ever close.
Hear our prayer.
For an end to the COVID pandemic, that God will heal the sick, strengthen the caregivers, and guide the distribution and administration of vaccines. God ever close.
Hear our prayer.
For peace, that the advent of the Prince of Peace may enlighten minds and hearts, to resolve disputes with words and deeds of compassion, and turn hearts from violence and domination. God ever close.
Hear our prayer.
We pray for those who are sick and for those who have asked for our prayers. We pray for those whom God has called from this life,
We make this our prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let's bow our heads and pray. Lord, in this sacrament we receive the promise of salvation. As Christmas draws near, make us grow in faith and love to celebrate the coming of Christ our Saviour, who is Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
Serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And with thanks to Emma and Olivia.